man begins to make his own rules. Verse 29, and even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. Being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. You see, the Bible describes a scenario of human behavior, of what takes place when man removes God from his thinking, when he rejects the evidence of creation. And when we look around us in the world today, the very things that Paul describes are the things that are happening. Time magazine, infidelity, it may be in our genes. Infidelity is the result of the evolutionary drive for humans to have as many offspring as possible with as many partners as possible, an evolutionary psychologist states. Newsweek, murder, a week in the death of America. Newsweek, America under the gun, what must be done? U.S. News, kids who kill. Newsweek, massacre in Colorado. And all these visuals are still in our minds. The things that are happening in this country. Violence goes mainstream. How could she do it? Parents killing their children. When violence hits home, evil, what makes people go wrong? The abortion issue. And now, even pills to kill children before they're born. What's happening to our society? Well, exactly what we would expect based on the biblical view, and particularly in a period of time called the last days. Paul, writing to Timothy in 2 Timothy in chapter 3, beginning in verse 1, this know also that in the last days perilous times will come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. From such, turn away. The very language used to describe human behavior in the last days is the same terminology that Paul uses in Romans chapter 1 to say this is what will happen to people who remove God from their thinking because they've accepted a lie. You see, this book gives us insight and understanding. Not only about the past. In the past 8 sessions, that's what we've been dealing with. A biblical view of the origin, the history of life, and we could see that you could back it up and support it with the observable evidence. But it also helps us to understand what takes place today, presently, in the world, to a society that removes God from their thinking. The Bible is true. I trust that this presentation will help us to better understand the
audience right now. And it's interesting, you know, that's what helped convince me later on as doubts came in. I started to believe on Jesus' words alone, but then I started studying prophecy and God would say that all these things are going to happen in the end times. Mm-hmm. And those things all interested me tremendously. And then they get even more concrete than this in a way, I mean, about cities and nations. But this is concrete in its own way, isn't it, Dave?
Absolutely. He said that there are only two possible choices, creation or evolution. Back to my dear mom again, she always says, well, I believe in God, you know, but I believe he created using evolution because she, like all the rest of us, has been told that, conditioned to believe that science simply has proven it, which it simply has not. Every single proof of evolution is not a proof. It's bad science. I don't care whether it's radiometric dating or the rock layers or the fossil record, and you know, you've got over that stuff a lot already, and there's tons of information if you want it. But if I don't know how much time, if I have time to read this. This is 2 Peter chapter 3.
One or two verses.
Oh.
He was reading right from there.
He was? Okay, I must have dozed off there.
Yeah. But you were looking for that scripture while he was reading it.
It's verses, check out 2 Peter. I would recommend the King James, but that's okay if it's
not
King James. Verse 1 through 15, read that. It's mind-blowing. He describes what's going to happen today. This is Paul 2,000 years ago.
This is an amazing thing. God says in Daniel, written around 500 and something B.C., mm-hmm. 2,500 years ago, that knowledge will increase in the earth, in the, mm-hmm. you know, towards the end. It's going to keep increasing. Mm-hmm. And that men will race around the globe, you know, around the earth. Mm-hmm. And so that's true. Knowledge has increased. But on the other hand, wouldn't you think, they always say, get education. You'd think that with knowledge, that you morally, you'd improve. But we're seeing a regression. You take the Ten Commandments from not being posted, take them out of the school system, do unto others, or you take just the golden rule, that's enough. Do unto others as you'd have them do to you. Whatsoever mm-hmm. you would that men do to you, do you therefore to them.
What's wrong with that?
Right. And if maybe some people thought about that a little more, they wouldn't shoot somebody else because they don't want to be shot.
You know, probably the most pluralistic, free society that's ever existed in this in history is the United States, which was based and founded on Christian biblical principles, which extended respect and freedom toward other people.
We have another caller, another fellow named Dick. Hi.
Hello.
Yeah.
I was just watching the program, and you mentioned the text about laying up on the first day of the week.
Yeah, I don't really want to belabor that point. You got something else?
I might be laboring it.
Okay, we don't want to even talk about it anymore tonight. You got another point you want to make?
Well, I wanted to quote the text, and it doesn't actually say the first day of the week. That's the only thing.
Yeah, no, it doesn't. Well, thank you for calling.
Yeah, what reference is that?
Well, if you look up the text, the actual wording is, it's the word is the first of the week.
Okay.
But it's interesting that the word for week is actually the same word that's translated Sabbath.
Well, that's something I hadn't thought of. I'll take a look at it one of these days. But thanks for calling.
Just look up in your concordance.
Yeah,
and look
okay.
up,
thank you.
The Greek word for the week, and you'll see it's the same word that's translated.
Have you ever seen our program before, Dick?
Oh, yeah, I've watched it.
Okay, cool. You're a Seventh-day Adventist, I guess? Or
mm-hmm.
Okay. Have you been on our website?
No, I'm not sure. I may have been on. I don't get on the computer that much on the internet.
Okay.
Well,
thanks for calling.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it gives it a little bit. I mean, actually, at the end of that.
Now, you don't have a problem with believers like us. It used to be some Seventh-day Adventists said you have to absolutely follow on Saturday, you're not going to be saved. You don't believe that, do you?
Well, I think you need to follow the Word of God. That's the only issue. But, I mean, that's, as you're...
To the best of your understanding, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
You're right. Well, thanks for calling. We got another call, and we've already talked about that subject. Thank you. Jeremy, how are you doing? Jeremy. Oh, we lost Jeremy. You're not there? Well, you can call back Jeremy or somebody. We've got about a minute and a half anyhow, so we can just... kind of finish up where we were with this concept that evolution has consequences, whether it's Nazism, Arianism. By the way, these the New Agers, Oprah Winfrey's into people who channel spirits, mm-hmm. and the people she's into are, you know, tied often to Alice Bailey, and the spirits that channel through her and many other spirits have said that they use the word Aryan for an evolved race. And that we're evolving spiritually, and that they're going to remove from the earth people who aren't open-minded enough to accept that, because it doesn't really matter. You're just going to go to a higher plane. You can evolve, reincarnate again anyhow. It's another way of getting rid of people like Hitler did. See you next week. We're on the next foreseeable number of Saturdays.
The creation evolution thing, it's not a matter of could God use evolution.